Hello friends, welcome to our channel Mechanical Motivator. Today we are going to see a basic problem on projection of solid. I will be initially telling the question and then I will be telling what are the given data we have to take from question and then I will be explaining step by step for drawing the diagram. A cylinder of base diameter 40 mm. So the diagram which we are going to draw is a cylinder and diameter of the circle is 40. So you have to take radius 20 mm and draw the circle. So diameter is 40. Altitude is 60. Altitude is 60 means height is 60 mm. Rest with one of its base point on HP. So resting would be on HP. Then one of the generator lines is inclined to 45 degree to HP. So the generator lines will be inclined 45 degree to HP and parallel to VP and we have to draw the projection. So initially our basic diagram would be a circle and we are going to draw the circle in HP. So initially first step will be we have to draw a reference line. The reference line we have to name it as XY. Then we have to name it as VP. VP means vertical plane, HP means horizontal plane. According to the question we have to draw the base diagram. So cylinder means the base diagram would be a circle. So circle will be having a diameter of 40 mm, radius is 20 mm. Take your compass, measure 20 mm in scale, then keep your compass and put this circle. So radius of the circle is 20 mm. Then we know how to divide the circle. So we have to divide the circle into 8 equal parts. It's more than enough. For dividing it, just divide it into first. Divide it into 4 equal parts like this. First divide it into 4 equal parts. Then keep your protractor here and measure 45 degree. Keep your protractor and measure 45 degree and draw a line and try to reverse it back. And keep your protractor here and draw another line for 45 degree and just reverse it back. So automatically we divide the circle into 8 equal parts. Naming we already know. So top surface will be ABCD and bottom surface will be 1, 2, 3, 4. So likewise we will be naming like this only ABCD, EF, till H and numerical part we won't be seeing because it will be cylinder means you can take an example also like this. See this water bottle, it's like a cylinder only. So here the top surface will be an alphabet and bottom surface will be a numerical one. So we just going to draw a circle and we have named like that. This is the top view. Only in top view we can see the exact or true shape of the diagram. Then we will be drawing the front view. Front view they have already given the altitude. Altitude means it's a height, right? So height will be 60 mm. So just draw a height for 60 mm and draw the box here. So one thing you have to remember, actually in cylinder we won't have any edges. See here we will be putting an edges, right? But in cylinder normally we won't be having any edges and all. So just focus on that and we will be having an axis line. So this is the axis line. Few of you will be getting confused, that is here we will be getting like an edge like this, but it's not right. We in cylinder we won't have edges at all. We will be having only the axis line. It is a curved part only, right? So for namesake of diagram sake we will be drawing like this. You have to focus only in your the axis line. This is our top view and this is our front view. While naming it, the alphabet will be coming at top face and 1, 2, 3, 4 will be coming at bottom face. Here we have to name like 1. So when you see from here, just see here, when you see from here, you can see 2 but you can't see 8. You can see 3, you can't see 7. You can see 4 but you can't see 6, you can see 5. That's what I have written here. In cylinder, only axis line will be there and there won't be any edges. Next thing is what they are telling us, they are asking us to incline the generator line. So this is the generator line. See here, this is the generator line and we have to incline only generator lines. Either we can incline this side or that side. So in my case I have just inclined that side. So this is my generator line. I am just going to replacing this diagram with an angle of 45 degree. So what you are going to do, you just measure this distance. So this distance will be 60 mm. So just keep a point anywhere in XY line and keep your protractor here and take 45 degree and draw that line for 60 mm. Now we have got this line, right? So just keep your protractor here and for 90 degree you draw a line so that you will be getting take the distance of this. You have to take the distance of this and draw that line. And here is also you have to take a 90 degree perpendicular line. So just take distance of this. So whatever the distance, you just draw as it is. And naming similar way, you have to measure this and keep this. And you have to measure here and keep there. Just exact replication of this diagram. We saw these things in previous videos also. And draw the diagram, the exact dimension. And see to it, the axis line should be drawn with your 2H pencil, HP pencil. And it should not be continuous. One dash should be bigger and one dash should be smaller. Next thing is, here we will be getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points, right? So just draw for all the 5 points. get those 5 points, go degree down. And here also same thing. Here we'll be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points. Get it go degree down. And here we'll be getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points. And just draw all the 5 points horizontal line. So these lines will be meeting at a point. For example, here you'll be getting 1, 2, 3, 4. And here you'll be getting alphabets. Just see here, this one and this one will be intersecting at this point. This two and this two will be intersecting at this point. Likewise, if you mark means, first of all, identify the intersection point and then we will be seeing which and all should be hidden. Now, just see here, I have just marked all the intersection points. Here we will be having numericals and here we will be having alphabets. So, after marking the intersection point, just see which edge or which corner touching XY line. So 5-1 dash is the only point just touching the XY line. Just see what are points connecting to it. But here we can't see here 5 and E is joined and 5 until 5-4 is joined, 5-6 is joined and 5-3 is joined, 5-7 is joined. So these and all should be hidden. So what I'm going to do is 5-6, 5-6-7, 5-4 and 5-3. See here actually if this is a water bottle or if this is a cylinder means when this cylinder is inclined to some angle and when you are seeing from the top view, you can see this side, you can see this circle and this circle you can see only half of it, you can't see it completely. That's what I am also drawing here, one side of circle. So this circle you can clearly see when you see from top view. So this is a top view and whatever we are drawing is a top view one. When you see from top view, you can see this circle but you can't see the entire circle, only half of it you can see. That's why I am just drawing only half of it as hidden, so only this part is hidden, whereas this side of circle you can clearly see. Now I will be joining all the remaining points. Now just join all the remaining edges. So you will be joining here, you will be joining this circle and you will be joining the remaining half of the circle and only one half will be hidden and this is called the axis line. The yellow color which I drawn is the axis line because in cylinder we will be representing only the axis line in between. So axis line should be shown from this middle of this cylinder till the middle of this cylinder. So you have to show the axis line. And dimensioning, we can dimension the height of the cylinder. So height is 60 mm and then diameter of the cylinder is 40 mm, so 540. And angle, these are the generator lines. So generator line is inclined at an angle of 45 degrees. So extension line should be in 2H pencil, dimension line should be in H pencil and arrow head should be in sharp pointed 3:1 ratio. And you have to leave some space at the, that is when you draw this diagram in your entry sheet, the heading should be in the center. So heading is the projection of cylinder. So projection of cylinder should be in center and it should be written with a capital letter. Height of the text is 10 mm. Then all dimensions are in mm, scale 1:1 should be written with 5 mm. And you have to write this all dimensions at the right bottom corner. Right bottom corner you have to write the all dimensions are in mm, scale 1:1. If you have any doubt, you can type in the comment section. If you feel this video is useful, means then you can share with your friends. And do subscribe my channel, Mechanical Motivator. Then only you can receive all the videos which I upload. Thanks for watching this video. Have a great day.